There's a drug, ketamine, that's been repurposed.
Right.
When I was preparing for the show, I learned something that I didn't know before.
Right.
Tell us about ketamine.
Yeah, well, ketamine is really a very exciting development in our field, and sort of an exception to the bad news I was telling you about with regards to the antidepressant medications. It's a medication that's been around for an awful long time, since the approved in the 60s, used, as you know, every day in medical centers like ours, as an anesthetic. It's used for treating pain, but it was discovered not too long ago that at much lower doses, it had a remarkable ability to, basically eliminate depression in people who have not responded. That group of people who I was alluding to, who have been through the regular conventional medications and therapy, and it does it very quickly. So we're.
Does that feel magical to you a little?
It does, because I've been in this field for a long time, and one of the things that we are not used to having something or be able to say to a patient, if this works, you're going to feel better in 24 hours. It's just not part of our vocabulary. And here, we can start saying that. Now tantalizing. It's very exciting in one way, but there is
because you start saying, why not just do that to everybody
exactly.
As a first-line treatment?
Right. So there are some Achilles heels to it. One of them is that the treatments tend not to last very long. So patients can get a wonderful and fast response. Not everyone does, but a large percent. But even then, it may only last for a day.
And then it tails off.
And then for some people, it may last for 5 days. So generally, the effect of a single ketamine treatment, whether it's intravenous or intramuscular, because we tend not to give it by the oral route because it's not as effective, is a matter of days to weeks. So the field is now trying to sort out how we can extended duration,
yeah.
Because then it would really manifest the potential of this drug. However, having said that, I have patients who have really not responded to anything and are getting ketamine treatments on a maintenance basis for anywhere from every 2 weeks to every 6 weeks. And it's changed their life. It's allowed them to live a full, life depression-free as long as they get the booster shots on a regular basis.
Yeah, and you can imagine the future science behind that, looking at combining that with other things.
Exactly.
Well, does that break the cycle and allow psychotherapy and or these other drugs to take effect, et cetera, et cetera?
Right.
There's a lot of work still to be done.
A lot of work, and one of the exciting things is that the ketamine works through a chemical signal in the brain that's completely distinct from all the ones that we have been pursuing with our antidepressants. So it's really, a standalone, mechanism. That tells us that there's there's a whole new potential science here to exploit and develop drugs based on ketamine's mechanism that might solve some of the problems like the short duration.